Welcome back, everyone. Today we are working on the Honda Hobbit Peugeot. I call it the Hug. Last year the timing slipped, and so we are going to set the timing on this Honda Hobbit engine. Normally these have a woodruff key and the timing is static, you can't change it. This one I do not use a woodruff key, so I can set the timing however I want it. This one also has a jog box, so it has a timing curve, which is really nice and gives it better performance, and it runs a little bit cooler. First thing we will do is take out the spark plug and find top dead center. Now we use this little tool and my fender gets in the way, so I'm gonna have to tilt the bike. Now we're just gonna rotate the flywheel until this tool reaches the top. Right there. That is top dead center. With top dead center, I'm gonna make a mark on the flywheel and the case. Okay, that is top dead center. Now we know where top dead center is and we can set our timing from this location. But first we have to figure out where the CDI sparks. The CDI, since the stator doesn't move, will always spark in the exact same position, like maybe right here or right here. And so we need to make a mark on the case to know exactly where the fire mark is. I'm gonna put the spark plug back in this boot and I have to make sure to ground the spark plug. So I'm just gonna use this little prong to make sure that it's grounded. And that way it'll spark and it won't damage the CDI. I'll then take the timing light and put that around the spark plug wire and connect the timing light terminals to this 12 volt battery from a Razor electric dirt bike. You can use a car battery as well, whatever's 12 volts. So the CDI fires right about here. Okay. And as it spins faster, it will retard and go a little bit this way, but it's gonna start right here. So now what we wanna do is rotate the engine so that the piston is 1.5 millimeters before top dead center. And then we wanna install the flywheel right there. So it'll spark right there when the piston is 1.5 millimeters before top dead center. So right now, if I go to top dead center and then go back this way, it's firing about 1 millimeter before top dead center. And so that works out to be about 17 degrees. And I want 20 to 22. So I want to rotate the crank more and then reinstall this. So put this on as straight as possible and it will pop off. There you go. We can turn the crank freely. Since this is a CDI and the stator doesn't move, we know that this flywheel is always gonna spark right there. So what we need to do now is rotate the crank and the piston so that the piston is before top dead center, exactly where we want it. And then we want to align the flywheel so it's right here, right when the piston is at 1.5 before top dead center, so that's where it sparks. So use your little tool and put it in here and then rotate it until you get to top dead center. Once you have top dead center, spin the engine counterclockwise, 1.5 millimeters, right there. So this is where we want the engine to be when we align the flywheel with the spark mark. So here's our line. And you want to get it on there without moving the crank. Now we can double check. If we rotate this to the top dead center mark, it should be 1.5 millimeters. Perfect. You do not need to check this with a timing light because we know that it always sparks right here. So this is where it's gonna spark. The only thing you need to really check this with is the spark plug indicator. Put your spark plug back in and you are done timing a Hobbit. Thank you all for watching. It's that easy to time a Hobbit. Just pull out that woodruff key if you want to get weird with it. Otherwise, leave the woodruff key in and it'll be stock timing. I'll put a link in the description for a timing light and the little timing tool. Please like and subscribe, and don't forget to stay tuned.